Headline news for Friday, May 6th from the Westchester County Business Journal, Fairfield County Business Journal, and WestfairOnline.com, Peter Katz reporting. The UN Food and Agricultural Organization says that while some Russian soldiers are killing people and destroying cities in Ukraine, others are stealing Ukrainian grain to take back to Russia. The UN says that an estimated 700,000 tons of Ukrainian grain is missing, and that there is anecdotal evidence that the Russians are stealing Ukrainian farm equipment. Ground was broken in Yonkers yesterday for a $585 million mixed-use project by Extel Development along the Hudson River. Known as Hudson Piers, the development will offer approximately 1,400 luxury and affordable apartments and a half-dozen seven-story buildings. The Business Journal learned that the first Hudson Piers building may be ready to open late next year. The City of Bridgeport Airport Commission has approved the sale of Bridgeport's Sikorsky Airport to the Connecticut Airport Authority for $10 million. The state's airport authority has promised more than $60 million in airport improvements and wants to bring back commercial airline service to Bridgeport. The Ridge Hill Shopping Center in Yonkers has been bought by a partnership of Nuveen Real Estate, Taconic Partners, and North American Properties for $220 million. The new owners are planning to renovate the 1.2 million square foot shopping center. The U.S. Bureau of Labor Statistics this morning reported widespread job growth in April, led by gains in leisure and hospitality, manufacturing, transportation, and warehousing. 428,000 jobs were added in April, with the unemployment rate holding steady from March at 3.6%. Elon Musk's company SpaceX this morning brought home four astronauts from the International Space Station. Splashdown was in waters off Tampa, Florida. Seven astronauts, three Russians, three Americans, and one Italian, are now on board the space station. Stay in touch with the Westchester County Business Journal, Fairfield County Business Journal, and WestfairOnline.com.